Very good morning. The National Council of Educational Research and Training heartily welcomes all of you to the 61st Foundation Day celebrations of NCERT. It was established on 1st September 1961 by the Government of India with the objective of qualitative improvement in school education in order to promote and coordinate research in areas related to school education, as well as enable and encourage diverse culture across the country. On the behalf of NCERT, I welcome our honorable guests, respected faculties and media people. It is an Indian tradition to light a lamp before commencing any auspicious event. With this belief, I would request our honorable guests to please light the lamp to inaugurate the Foundation Day event 2021. Our honorable guests are requested to proceed. Honorable Minister of State for Education, Government of India, Dr. Subhash Sarkar. Honorable Minister of State for Education, Government of India, Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh. Honorable Joint Secretary Institution, Department of School Education and Literacy, Ministry of Education, Government of India, Mrs. L.S. Chang San. Respected Director, NCERT, Professor Sridhar Srivastava. Respected Secretary, NCERT, Major Harsh Kumar. Respected Joint Director, CIT, NCERT, Professor Amrendra Behra. Thank you. The goddess Saraswati, who is worshipped as the mother of Vedas. Let's hear to this mellifluous Saraswati Vanna, sung by the students of Kendra Vidyalaya Sector 2, R.K. Puram.
Ya Kundendu Tushar Har Dhavala Ya Shubhra Vastra Veenava Ya Padmasana Ya Brahma Chut Shankar Prabhriti Bhirdeva Sada Vandita Mabhatu Saraswati Mabhatu Saraswati Bhagavati
हर प्रकाश भर जगमग जग कर दे
Respected Director NCERT Professor Sridhar Srivastav to kindly felicitate Honorable Minister of State for Education, Government of India, Dr. Subhash Sarkar. Thank you. Now I would request respected Joint Director CIT NCERT Professor Amrinder Behra to kindly felicitate Honorable Minister of State for Education, Government of India, Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh. Thank you. Now I would request respected Dean Academics NCERT Professor Anjum Sibia to kindly felicitate Honorable Joint Secretary Institutions Department of School Education and Literacy, Ministry of Education, Government of India, Mrs. L.S. Chang San. Thank you. Now, I would request Honorable Joint Director CIT NCERT Professor Amrinder Behra to kindly welcome all respected dignitaries.
Hey everyone, Honorable Minister of Education for States, Ministry of Education, Sarkarji, Honorable Minister of Education for States, Ministry of Education, Government of India, esteemed Madam Mrs. L.S. Changshan, Joint Secretary looking after bureau heads, Ministry of Education, Government of India, Sridhar Srivastav ji, esteemed Secretary NCERT, Major Harsh Kumar ji, distinguished colleagues from NCERT, all the former directors and secretaries who are with us online and watching us on YouTube official channel, esteemed principals of all the five regional institute of education in NCERT, Pandit Sundarlal Sharma Central Institute of Vocational Education, distinguished colleagues from states, UTs, National Awardee teachers, and other teachers who are watching, and our NCERT alumni, including maybe many IAS aspirants who are using NCERT books, and ladies and gentlemen, personal behalf, on behalf of the council, and on behalf of the Ministry of Education, Government of India, all the honorable minister of state for education and the joint secretary and other dignitaries to this function for celebrating completion of 60 years of NCERT and also entering upon the 61st foundation day of NCERT. So once again, sir, welcome to all of you to this function. As all of us, we know NCERT since last more than 6 decades have been working in the area of curriculum development, continuous capacity building of teachers, research, training and extension activities, and have been working towards achieving the policy goals, which was released last year by Government of India, Ministry of Education, is under implementation. And we assure you, sir, and to the ministry, that NCERT will not leave any stone untouched to work on quality education and also impart quality education in school and teacher education across the country. With these words, once again, I welcome all of you, including both the honorable ministers and the Joint Secretary, Ministry of Education, and the other dignitaries. Thank you very much. Namaskar.
Thank you. Now I would request Honorable Director NCERT Professor Sridhar Srivastav to take us down memory lane, 60 years long journey of NCERT.
Oh, a very good afternoon. Honorable Education Minister Sri Dharmendra Pradhan ji, we have received his blessings today. Honorable Minister of State Sri Subhas Sarkar ji, Honorable Minister of State Sri Rajkumar Ranjan ji, Joint Secretary, School Education, JS Institution, Madam L.S. Changshan ji, Joint Director CIT, Professor Behra, Secretary NCERT, Major Harsh Kumar, all former directors who have joined us virtually, former principals, present principals of RIs, joint director passive, all retired faculty, and the present strength of faculty and staff of all the constituents in NCERT, heads of the department of NI and CIT who are present here in this room. And I would also like to remember all those personalities or contributors. They are presently in this world or not in this world, but they have made, by their contribution, imprints in the area of school education. And all others who are viewing this program, media people, ladies and gentlemen. This organization has seen 60 years, and it is a long journey. The organization, which was established in 1961, is an apex institution in the field of education and has developed an expertise for school education and teacher education. The organization has a national presence through its 8 constituents spread across 6 campuses in this country and 4 regional production cum distribution centers. And the organization have a student strength coming from the whole country. And this organization has modern studios for direct telecast of educational programs. The program which we are participating right now is also being viewed across the country through YouTube and channels on television also. And we have libraries and resource centers, audiovisual libraries, computer labs. NCERT, being an institution of higher learning, share the national vision of providing inclusive education to the whole country. And I am very pleased to welcome you all on the 60th year of this institution and on this occasion of 61st Foundation Day of NCERT. If we look back to the journey of NCERT, the organization has contributed in DPEP. It has contributed in Operation Blackboard, PMOST, EMAS, Orientation of School Teachers, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, Right to Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act, National Skills Qualification Framework, ICT at Schools Scheme, Samagra Shiksha, Navoda Vidyalaya Scheme started. Sir, I would like to just... Sir, learning out in the narrative of discussion in respect of teaching learning process, and we have tried to instill this in the mind of all concerns and functionaries that we have to keep learning outcomes in the fore of all teaching learning interventions. National Achievement Survey for Class 3, 5, 8, and 10, which was conducted in 2017 at the district level, and development of framework for post-NAS intervention has also emphasized upon the competency-based learning and how interventions can be planned at district level for enhancing the learning outcomes of children. National Initiative for School Heads and Teacher Holistic Advancement, NISTA, which was intended to train 42 lakhs teachers in the country, sir. It was started in 2019. And when we saw the pandemic in 2020, we moved to the online states, and we are making further moves in that direction. Strengthening of SCRT is a major initiative in which this organization has contributed under the aegis of Ministry of Education. Provide solutions on various aspects of school education has been very close to our heart. Inclusive education materials for visually impaired children, tactile maps, tactile material for maths books, we have developed, sir. Development of educational kits in science, mathematics, language, and social science we have paid efforts in that direction also. Program on health and well-being in schools is a major initiative that we have initiated under our NPEP initiatives, and we are getting good response from states and for senior school students, we have developed SIR, and it is getting good response. Developing course modules for MOOCs, we have 31 courses being offered by our institution, CIT. Launching of innovative vocational education in our demonstrative school undertaken at RI Bhopal, one of our constituents. International collaboration and linkages, memorandum of understanding, Australia, Germany, Mauritius, USA, and very recently with Taiwan. We have moved in that direction. About 350 titles of textbooks, accounting to 6 crore copies in Hindi, English, and Urdu, and other materials and their dissemination, and we get good response. In the form of energized textbooks, QR code embedded, e-resources mapped to textbooks, and vocational education area also, we have come out with our textbooks for different job roles. This is a recent initiative, sir. E-Pathshala and National Repository of Open Educational Resources, we are having abundance of material for the use of. Recent times, sir, during pandemic also, alternative academic calendar for all stages of teachers and parents, along with a worry for their mental health also, we are there with our suggestions, recommendation, how to handle the mental health of children during the pandemic situations. We have come out with the guidelines to prevent cyber bullying, sir. Pragyata, a guideline for online digital education. It was an effort of NCERT and last year during the pandemic time. Students Learning Enhancement Guideline. Nishtha Online on Diksha. This is a very good initiative, sir. We have now moved to online rolling out of our Nishtha program. Live daily telecast in 4 slots for academic calendars. This follows our publication of alternative academic calendars. It is synced with that. E-content for 12 channels, daily telecast with their programs. Sir, we are making all efforts to reach to the children and provide a situation of coherent access to children and teachers. Counseling services for school students under Sahyog and very recently, sir, you both were witness to that. We saw our Honorable Prime Minister launching the Vidya Pravesh guideline, which will impact upon the early childhood state functionaries, its institutions and agencies. NISTA for secondary stage has been launched, and the FLN NISTA, which is for the foundational literacy numeracy, that is being that has been launched, and it will be following the FLN Nipun mission launched by government. These are certain recent initiative, and most importantly, sir, presently, we are involved in enacting the national curriculum framework for school education, teacher education, adult education, and early childhood care and education. With the support of state governments and its functionary with a bottom-up approach. Sir, we are making all attempts to create such an to its culture and sound foundations with a global relevance at the present time, sir. And we are also trying to reimagine vocational education in a manner so that it is linked to skills and entrepreneurship in the country to give strength to the hands of great population in this country. Sir, before I end, I would like to place forth one point here. I want to make a point that is in reference of NCERT. With great vigor and drive, making a national as well as international impact. National importance. NCERT status can function as a premier public education institution in India, having its own courses and giving degrees under its own name. In addition to carrying quality research in the area of education and educational development, we want to expand our domains of research and professional development, sir. The institution can potentially be looked at as an initiative and as an institution producing a cadre of professionals to lead the reforms in the educational level. Once strengthened as an institution to develop professionals at par with global level, it can work for strengthening linkages between school education, higher education, vocational education, and teacher education. Also, collaboration with international organizations for mutual sharing support and exchange program can be realized through its master's research degree programs. Sir, we have National Education Policy 2020, which has given us many great roles to perform as an institution. On this occasion today, sir, I seek you all's blessings for this Foundation Day and for giving strength to this institution to proceed further and add many more glories to its fold. Sir, with these humble words, I am very happy that you all were kind enough to accept the invitation. We started a little late. My apology to the viewers who are joining virtually, but we had heavy rain today here in Delhi and traffic. So we started a little late. So again, I am very grateful to all who are viewing this program and to all others who are showering their blessings to us today. With this, thanks and Jai Hind.
Thank you. It is very difficult to sum up the establishment, history, and achievements of 60 years of NCERT.
NCERT, एक अनवरत शैक्षिक यात्रा। राष्ट्रीय शैक्षिक अनुसंधान और प्रशिक्षण परिषद NCERT की स्थापना 1 सितंबर 1961 को भारत सरकार द्वारा एक स्वायत्त शासी संस्थान के रूप में हुई। शिक्षा मंत्रालय भारत सरकार के अंतर्गत यह प्रमुख राष्ट्र स्तरीय शैक्षिक संस्थान है जो विद्यालयी शिक्षा के सभी क्षेत्रों में अपना योगदान देता आ रहा है। एनसीईआरटी के प्रतीक चिन्ह को कर्नाटक के रायचूर जिले में पुरातत्व उत्खनन में मिली तीसरी शताब्दी के अशोक काल के एक अवशेष से अपनाया गया है। इस प्रतीक चिन्ह में दर्शाए गए ये तीन हंस एनसीईआरटी के मुख्य तीन कार्यों के द्योतक हैं, अनुसंधान व विकास, प्रशिक्षण और विस्तार। स्थापना से आज तक की यात्रा में एनसीईआरटी ने देश की शैक्षिक आवश्यकताओं के अनुरूप स्वयं का विस्तार किया है, जिसके परिणाम हैं NIE यानी राष्ट्रीय शिक्षा संस्थान, 5 क्षेत्रीय शिक्षा संस्थान और केंद्रीय शैक्षिक प्रौद्योगिकी संस्थान और पंडित सुंदरलाल शर्मा केंद्रीय व्यावसायिक शिक्षा संस्थान। किसी भी देश में शिक्षा की अनुकूल नीतियों का निर्धारण, समुचित प्रबंधन तथा व्यवस्था पूर्णतः इस बात पर निर्भर करती है कि वहाँ गुणवत्तापूर्ण शोध कार्य कितने विस्तृत और व्यापक स्तर पर होता है। इस संदर्भ में NCERT के सभी संकायों द्वारा स्कूली शिक्षा को ग्राह्य, रुचिकर और आनंददायी बनाने के लिए निरंतर शोध होता रहता है। साथ ही साथ विद्यालयी शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में युवा शोधार्थियों को प्रेरित करने के लिए भी प्रदान की जाती है। परिषद के समृद्ध पुस्तकालय में सभी शोधार्थियों के लिए उत्तम और अद्यतन शोध सामग्री उपलब्ध है। समसामयिक शोध को प्रोत्साहन देने के लिए NCERT की शैक्षिक शोध और नवाचार समिति इस क्षेत्र में विशेष रूप से कार्यरत है। विद्यालयी शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में हुए शोध शैक्षिक शोधों के सर्वेक्षणों के रूप में संकलित और प्रकाशित किए जाते हैं। शोधों के संकलन का यह कार्य परिषद में सतत रूप से जारी है। नवीनतम शोधों और शिक्षा के अन्य ज्वलंत मुद्दों की पहुंच हितधारकों तक संभव बनाने के लिए परिषद द्वारा अनेक शोध पत्रिकाओं का प्रकाशन भी किया जाता है। प्रारंभिक बाल्यावस्था देखभाल और शिक्षा सीखने की नींव है। इस पर शोध, दिशा निर्देश पाठ्यक्रम और नवाचारी सामग्री विकसित करना NCERT के प्रमुख कार्यों में से एक है। आज इसी क्रम में निपुण भारत मिशन शिक्षा मंत्रालय भारत सरकार की एक महत्वपूर्ण पहल है। इस अभियान के सुचारू और सफल संचालन के लिए NCERT निरंतर प्रयासरत है। इस क्रम में बुनियादी साक्षरता एवं संख्या ज्ञान सीखने की एक तात्कालिक आवश्यकता और पूर्व शर्त के रूप में उभर कर सामने आई है। शिक्षा में समता सुनिश्चित करने के लिए इसे समावेशी बनाना अपरिहार्य है। इस दिशा में NCERT द्वारा शोध, संसाधन निर्माण और प्रशिक्षण संबंधी ऐसे अनेक प्रयास किए गए हैं जिससे दिव्यांगों, समाज के पिछड़े वर्गों, विशेष आवश्यकता वाले बच्चों, अनुसूचित जाति और जनजातियों और अल्पसंख्यक समूहों के बच्चों के लिए समावेशी शिक्षा को सुनिश्चित किया जा सके और इन प्रयासों के लाभ शिक्षकों और अभिभावकों तक भी पहुँच सके। शिक्षा का अधिकार अधिनियम ने इन प्रयासों को और अधिक सशक्त किया है और इसके द्वारा बहुत से सामाजिक अवरोध भी समाप्त हुए हैं। NCERT द्वारा पिछले कई दशकों से चलाया जा रहा परामर्श एवं मार्गदर्शन डिप्लोमा पाठ्यक्रम बहुत लोकप्रिय है। COVID-19 के विषम काल में NCERT द्वारा प्रशिक्षित विशेषज्ञों द्वारा विद्यार्थियों, शिक्षकों एवं अभिभावकों के लिए मनोदर्पण मंच के माध्यम से मनोपरामर्श एवं मार्गदर्शन प्रदान किया जा रहा है। परीक्षा की प्रक्रिया आकलन और मूल्यांकन की नवाचारी प्रविधियां सुनिश्चित करने के क्षेत्र में भी NCERT पीछे नहीं है। सतत और व्यापक मूल्यांकन संबंधित शोध और सामग्री निर्मित करने, आरंभिक और माध्यमिक अवस्थाओं के लिए अधिगम के प्रतिफल यानी लर्निंग आउटकम्स और विद्यालय आधारित मूल्यांकन इत्यादि कुछ ऐसे प्रयास हैं जो आकलन और मूल्यांकन के क्षेत्र में बहुत उपयोगी सिद्ध हुए हैं। NCERT द्वारा प्रकाशित पाठ्य पुस्तकों और अन्य पाठ्य सामग्रियों को कौन नहीं जानता। वर्षों से उच्च गुणवत्ता वाली इन पुस्तकों का विस्तृत रूप से असंख्य लोगों द्वारा इस्तेमाल किया जाता रहा है। प्रकाशन विभाग द्वारा प्रतिवर्ष लगभग 5 करोड़ पुस्तकों का प्रकाशन किया जाता है। इन पुस्तकों के निर्माण का आधार होती है राष्ट्रीय शिक्षा नीति पर आधारित NCERT द्वारा समय समय पर निर्मित राष्ट्रीय पाठ्यचर्या की रूपरेखा। न केवल पाठ्य सामग्री अपितु NCERT में गुणवत्तापूर्ण शैक्षिक ऑडियो वीडियो व मल्टीमीडिया कार्यक्रम व स्पर्शी मानचित्र भी विशेष आवश्यकताओं की पूर्ति के लिए विकसित किए जाते हैं। कक्षा 1 से 12 तक की सभी पाठ्य पुस्तकों को QR कोड के माध्यम से ऊर्जित करने, ध्वनि रूपांतरण, भारतीय सांकेतिक भाषा तथा डेजी प्रारूप में रूपांतरित करने की प्रक्रिया अनवरत जारी है। परिषद द्वारा शिक्षकों व शिक्षक प्रशिक्षकों हेतु नवाचारी, शिक्षण, आकलन एवं मूल्यांकन प्रविधियों, शिक्षा प्रौद्योगिकी, जेंडर, समावेशी शिक्षा और शैक्षिक नेतृत्व जैसे अनेक विषयों पर राष्ट्रव्यापी प्रशिक्षणों का भी आयोजन किया जाता है। शिक्षक प्रशिक्षण की दिशा में एनसीईआरटी द्वारा आयोजित निष्ठा संभवतः दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा शिक्षक प्रशिक्षण कार्यक्रम है। इसे अगस्त 2019 में आरंभ किया गया था। इसमें राज्य संसाधन समूहों द्वारा शिक्षकों से प्रत्यक्ष संवाद की प्रक्रिया स्थापित की गई। कोविड-19 महामारी के दौरान इस कार्यक्रम को दीक्षा पोर्टल के माध्यम से ऑनलाइन मोड में उपलब्ध कराया गया ताकि देश के सभी प्राथमिक शिक्षकों तक 2019 में शुरू किए गए इस प्रशिक्षण का लाभ पहुंचाया जा सके। इस क्रम में देश के सभी माध्यमिक, उच्च और उच्चतर माध्यमिक शिक्षकों के लिए इस प्रशिक्षण कार्यक्रम का विस्तार किया जा रहा है। एनसीईआरटी द्वारा शीघ्र ही बुनियादी साक्षरता एवं संख्या ज्ञान के लिए भी शिक्षकों के ऑनलाइन प्रशिक्षण की शुरुआत की जाएगी। इस महती अभियान में शिक्षा मंत्रालय भारत सरकार की एक अभिनव पहल दीक्षा डिजिटल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फॉर नॉलेज शेयरिंग का अभूतपूर्व योगदान रहा। दीक्षा एक विकेंद्रित डिजिटल आधारभूत संरचना है जो सीखने सिखाने की प्रक्रिया में ज्ञान को परस्पर साझा करने के उत्तम अवसर प्रदान करती है। महामारी के दौरान यह पोर्टल न केवल शिक्षक प्रशिक्षण अपितु कक्षा 1 से 12 के विद्यार्थियों के साथ डिजिटल पाठ्य पुस्तकें एवं संसाधन साझा करने का एक अनूठा माध्यम साबित हुआ। इस क्रम में ई पाठशाला एवं NROER जैसे डिजिटल माध्यम भी बहुत सहायक सिद्ध हुए। यही नहीं, महामारी के दौरान लगभग 25 करोड़ बच्चों की शैक्षिक आवश्यकता को ध्यान में रखते हुए प्राथमिक, उच्च प्राथमिक तथा माध्यमिक स्तर पर वैकल्पिक अकादमिक कैलेंडर का निर्माण किया गया। इसे सारे राज्यों और केंद्र शासित प्रदेशों में लागू किया गया है। शिक्षा मंत्रालय भारत सरकार द्वारा पीएम ई विद्या नामक देशव्यापी शैक्षिक अभियान प्रारंभ किया गया, जिसके तहत एनसीईआरटी ने मंत्रालय की एक कक्षा एक चैनल की अवधारणा को साकार करते हुए कक्षा 1 से 12 के लिए 12 चैनलों पर पाठ्यक्रम आधारित वीडियो कार्यक्रमों का प्रसारण शुरू किया। यह भी सुनिश्चित किया गया कि सुदूर पर्वतीय ग्रामीण अंचलों तक भी शैक्षिक कार्यक्रम पहुंचे। इस क्रम में देश भर के कुल 226 रेडियो प्रसारण केंद्रों से शैक्षिक कार्यक्रमों का प्रसारण किया जा रहा है। जियो सावन मोबाइल ऐप और आई रेडियो द्वारा एनसीईआरटी के रेडियो कार्यक्रमों की पहुंच अब वैश्विक हो गई है। एनसीईआरटी के विभिन्न संघटकों द्वारा शिक्षकों एवं शिक्षार्थियों के लिए अनेक रोचक और मनोरंजक आयोजन, प्रतियोगिताएं और पुरस्कार आयोजित किए जाते हैं, जिनमें प्रमुख हैं कला उत्सव, योग ओलंपियाड, भाषा संगम, सामुदायिक गायन, शैक्षिक मीडिया कार्यक्रमों के निर्माण में गुणवत्ता लाने और इनमें शिक्षकों और छात्रों की भागीदारी भी सुनिश्चित करने हेतु प्रतिवर्ष अखिल भारतीय शैक्षिक बाल ऑडियो वीडियो फेस्टिवल और ICT मेला का आयोजन किया जाता है। इसमें देश भर के सर्वोत्कृष्ट कार्यक्रम निर्माताओं को पुरस्कार प्रदान किए जाते हैं। हाल ही में आयोजित भारतीय आभासी खिलौना मेला में NCERT द्वारा निर्मित डिजिटल खेल एवं शैक्षिक किट्स भी प्रदर्शित किए गए। शिक्षा में नवाचार को बढ़ावा देने के लिए शिक्षकों और शिक्षक प्रशिक्षकों को राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर पुरस्कृत किया जाता रहा है। ये पुरस्कार अब रूपांतरित स्वरूप में नवाचारी विद्यालयों और शिक्षक प्रशिक्षण संस्थाओं को दिए जाते हैं। NCERT द्वारा देश भर के उन शिक्षकों को सम्मानित किया जाता है जिन्होंने सूचना और संचार प्रौद्योगिकी ICT का उपयोग करके सीखने सिखाने की प्रक्रिया को मनोरंजक और रुचिकर बनाया है। पर्यावरण, विज्ञान और गणित के क्षेत्र में बच्चों में वैज्ञानिक चिंतन विकसित करने के उद्देश्य से एनसीईआरटी द्वारा देश भर में राष्ट्रीय प्रदर्शनी का आयोजन किया जाता है। इस प्रदर्शनी में विद्यार्थी अपनी नवाचारी प्रतिभा का प्रदर्शन करते हैं। एनसीईआरटी द्वारा राष्ट्रीय प्रतिभा खोज योजना के तहत देशव्यापी परीक्षाओं के माध्यम से मेधावी विद्यार्थियों की पहचान की जाती है और उन्हें स्नातकोत्तर स्तर तक वित्तीय सहायता प्रदान की जाती है। शिक्षा की गुणवत्ता को बनाए रखने के लिए एनसीईआरटी द्वारा विभिन्न मंत्रालयों के साथ सहभागिता में कार्य किया जाता है, साथ ही साथ अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर भी अनेकानेक सहयोग व समझौते किए जाते हैं। वर्तमान समय में भारत की स्वतंत्रता की 75वीं वर्षगांठ के अंतर्गत देश भर में आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव मनाया जा रहा है। इस उपलक्ष्य को केंद्र मानकर एनसीईआरटी द्वारा अनेक कार्यक्रमों और गतिविधियों का आयोजन किया जा रहा है। सर्वविदित है कि एनसीईआरटी विद्यालयी शिक्षा से संबद्ध विषयों पर केंद्र सरकार की प्रमुख परामर्शदात्री संस्था है। भारत सरकार ने 2020 में नवीनतम राष्ट्रीय शिक्षा नीति की घोषणा की, जिसके विमर्श, विकास और दस्तावेजीकरण में एनसीईआरटी की महती भूमिका रही है। राष्ट्रीय शिक्षा नीति शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में आमूलचूल परिवर्तन की बात करती है। नीति यह भी सुनिश्चित करने पर बल देती है कि शिक्षा रोजगारोन्मुखी होने के साथ साथ अंतर्राष्ट्रीय प्रतिमानों और मानकों के अनुकूल भी हो। एनसीईआरटी शिक्षा नीति की संस्तुतियों को लागू करने के प्रति पूर्णतः कटिबद्ध है। इस आशा के साथ कि देश में विद्यालयी शिक्षा और शिक्षक शिक्षा का भविष्य और अधिक उज्ज्वल होगा, एनसीईआरटी आप सबके सहयोग को ज्ञापित करते हुए आज अपनी स्थापना के 61वें वर्ष में प्रवेश करती है।
NCERT production team for taking us through this beautiful 60 years journey of NCERT. Through a recorded video, Honorable Minister of Education, Government of India, Shri Dharmendra Pradhan has congratulated NCERT for a successfully completing 60 years and shared the word of wisdom with us. Let's watch it.
डॉक्टर सुभाष सरकार जी,
डॉक्टर सुभाष सरकार,
डॉक्टर राजकुमार रंजन सिंह,
डॉक्टर
श्रीमती अन्नपूर्णा देवी जी, श्रीमती अनीता करवाल जी, सेक्रेटरी स्कूल एजुकेशन, प्रोफेसर श्रीधर श्रीवास्तव, डायरेक्टर एनसीईआरटी, मेजर हर्ष कुमार, सेक्रेटरी एनसीईआरटी, फैकल्टी, स्टाफ मेंबर्स, टीचर्स एंड माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय ग्रीटिंग्स टू ऑल ऑफ यू। इट गिव्स मी इमेंस प्लेजर टू बी ए पार्ट ऑफ द सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ 61st Foundation Day of the National Council of Educational Research and Training, NCERT. It is heartening to see that the institution has undertaken a long journey of 60 years and remains dedicated to India's education sector. In the same spirit, I congratulate the entire family of NCERT for achieving this significant milestone. Friends, there has been immense improvement in the quality of school education in India since independence, and NCERT has played an instrumental role in it. All these years, NCERT has set its benchmark by coordinating efforts with more than 97 lakhs teachers, 26 crore students and 15 lakhs schools across the country. From formulating the National Curricular Framework, NCF, to releasing the alternative academic calendar during the odd circumstance of COVID-19, NCERT has done a commendable job of supporting a standard system of education in India. I am sure that as NCERT celebrates its 61st Foundation Day, it will not only evaluate its past initiatives but will also gear up for the future. Today, under the esteemed leadership of Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji, the entire Indian education system is set to witness a massive transformation. As you all know, we have introduced the National Education Policy 2020 to provide accessible, affordable, equitable and quality education to all, while adhering to an international outlook in tune with the needs of the 21st century. The policy has based on Indian ethos and instilled a deep-rooted pride in being Indian amongst the learners. As far as school education is concerned, we have set a 100% GER goal by the year 2030. With the new 5+3+3+4 school system and significant recommendations such as the holistic progress card and flexibility in the choice of subjects, the policy will bring a paradigm shift from the what to think to how to think. As we move ahead with the implementation of the policy, I am sure we shall experience this change amongst our children in no time. Friends, I believe that NEP 2020 has provided us with an opportune moment when we can decide the quality of education that will be imparted to our children. We must prioritize strengthening our school education system as it lays the foundation of our entire education ecosystem. I am sure that in tune with the NEP 2020, National Curriculum Framework for School Education and other subsequent curriculum frameworks to be developed by NCERT will enable us to explore and nurture children's talent by restructuring the stages of curriculum and pedagogy across schools in the country. With these words, I once again congratulate NCERT on its 61st Foundation Day. My best wishes to you all. Thank you, friends. Jai Hind.
Thank you, friends. Jai Hind.
Thank you. Honorable Minister of Education, in his message, he focused on the National Education Policy 2020, under which he talked about developing skills, positive attitude, resilience to overcome challenges to create a better society. Thank you for your wishes, sir. Now, I would request Honorable Joint Secretary Institutions, Department of School Education and Literacy, Ministry of Education, Mrs. L.S. Chang San, to address the esteemed audience. Ma'am, you can speak from there.
Namaskar. Honorable Minister of Education, Sri Dharmendra Pradhan, sir. Honorable Minister of State Education, Dr. Subhash Sarkar, sir. Honorable Minister of State for Education, Sri Rajkumar Ranjan Singh, sir. Director NCERT, Professor Sridhar Srivastav. Joint Director CIET, Dr. Professor Amrendra Behra, members of the NCERT faculty, Secretary NCERT, principals of all the constituent units, RIEs of NCERT at different locations, all the faculty and staff members, and family of NCERT, and all the friends who are viewing this program, students and media persons. At the outset, I would like to convey my heartiest congratulations to NCERT on completing 60 years. And entering on the 61st year on this occasion of 61st Foundation Day. Our Secretary, School Education and Literacy, Srimati Anita Karwal, who could not be present here due to certain other engagements, has conveyed her heartiest greetings on this occasion and her congratulations to the entire NCERT team. This is really a very auspicious occasion. 60 years, actually it's a, others would call it the Diamond Jubilee. Of its existence. And really, I think that NCERT has come a long way from its initial days till today, having come through national education policies over the years and framing of the national curriculum framework and the different syllabus and developing textbooks for school education all these years. NCERT is in fact the premier nation has mandated for an academic authority, and the Ministry of Education has designated NCERT the academic authority for all purposes of school education. And indeed, the NCERT has been living up to its purpose. In the field of research, training in school education, in teachers' preparation, and in all spheres of new approaches in curriculum, new approaches in pedagogy, NCERT has been spearheading all these developments and has been leading, has been the leading pioneer, I would say, in different aspects of school education. Even as described by the director in his who spoke just now, and in the film that we all watched, a beautifully produced film, I must add, we have seen that NCERT has been involved over the decades in all key government programs in under the Ministry of Education, all the major flagship schemes which have been undertaken by the ministry. NCERT has been really the backbone in helping to develop all the guidelines and schemes, and it has really played an important part, even I would say in the past year even more so, with the launch of the new National Education Policy 2020. Last year onwards, we had an unprecedented time due to the pandemic, and we have all gone through the never before status with schools and educational institutions closed. But NCERT has stepped in to fill the gap, and under the Ministry of Education has come up with excellent innovations like the alternative academic calendar. And when online education seemed to become the only way of reaching to all the millions of students across the country, even then NCERT has come in with the online education guidelines, Pragyata, and really amped up the PM eVidya program with so many different components under it, from Diksha to Ipachala to the One Nation, One Class, Classroom, One Channel program. And it has shown the way to so many other states and union territories and different constituent units, people all who are in the education sector. In today's times, we are still under this kind of pandemic situation. However, thanks to the interventions by this great August institution, I would say that a number of children have been able to benefit hugely from this. And we have seen the number of crores of hits on even the Diksha platform. And make up the shortfall, if any, in any of any learning loss that may have occurred in the past year. NCERT has been also coming up with novel approaches in teaching learning, and amongst them, apart from the ICT, the technology related, in the field of now new pedagogies, in the field of inclusive education, in the field of now the foundational literacy and numeracy, which is given prime position, prime importance in the new NEP, and even new initiatives like toy pedagogy, which we saw from last year, and it has really picked up a lot, and the institution played a great role even in the India Toy Fair, which was launched for the first time. We are hopeful that we will soon be getting a fully developed toy pedagogy soon to be implemented in our schools. Teacher training has been another strong area of NCERT with the different courses which are being introduced. And the Nishtha, it goes without saying that it has really, I think, excited the minds of a whole lot of teachers in different states across the country. And it has promised, and it has turned out to be also a very new, innovative, activity-based teacher training program. When a lot of teacher training programs had become quite run-of-the-mill and quite repetitive, I do believe Nishtha has shown a way forward that teachers can be invigorated and can be strengthened, their capacity built, so that the actual this teacher training translates into benefited. NCERT has been closely involved in different guidelines and different initiatives of this ministry. Even I remember the school safety guidelines which were prepared for ensuring safe environment in the school. NCERT has been a close part of that. The school health program with the school wellness ambassadors, that has also been really well received in the schools. And I do believe that such initiatives will go a long way in making the education feel very diverse and very active, vibrant environment. We have also seen different approaches like the art integrated learning. Now CBSE has also made it a mandatory part, and in the field of physical education too, and identifying and nurturing gifted children. That is one other area which the ministry has been looking at, and the NEP also prescribes that. Kala Utsav has been a very successful program of the NCERT. Every year since the last 5 years, this has been conducted successfully, and we have been able to identify so many children, which in fact resonates with the spirit of NEP, that we are not to look at only the academic academic performance of a child. We are to look at his or her so many other different capabilities, different abilities, different talents. And this is really one way of looking at education in a holistic way. We keep on talking about holistic education, but NCERT is already practically carrying this out through its various initiatives, and I heartily applaud this. Now, there is a long road ahead. 60 years in all these years, the organization has indeed gained immensely from all its wisdom. And I'm sure that in the years to come, NCERT will reevaluate, will revisit all the experiences that it has gone through. With the new national curriculum framework to be developed by NCERT, therein lies the very first challenge ahead, to develop the new curriculum framework, to bring out new syllabus, to bring out the new textbooks in alignment in the context of the new national education policy. I think it's a huge, huge task, and I would earnestly request that every member, every of this NCERT fraternity be keenly involved. You have your own years of personal experience in the field of education, and this is one area where this is the time when everybody should come together and work on this, because this is the most critical, crucial aspect, developing the new curriculum framework and syllabus and textbooks, covering all areas of new interventions, new approaches that we have mentioned, that is mentioned in the policy. And apart from that, all the related aspects, be it the National Achievement Survey that is going to be conducted even in the midst of this pandemic, and the examination and assessment reforms, the new teacher training reforms, early childhood education. So many areas are there. And not to mention the very important area of social and emotional well-being, mental health of the students. Manodarpan has been a key program of the NCERT, which was launched last year. And I'm sure it has really come in good stood in good stead and helped so many students who were in need of very crucial counseling support at a very challenging time. So in the years ahead, and in the immediate short term and medium term, long term, again, internalize, reevaluate itself, and move on from its positions of strength to greater achievements. And I'm sure that all members of the faculty would contribute. I appreciate that this is a very democratic, open-minded organization where everybody's ideas and contributions are welcomed. And I've seen this functioning as JS institutions too, that all aspects are deliberated upon by members, different committees, before you come to any finalization of any scheme or guideline or any new innovation. I hope that this spirit, this tradition continues in the years to come, and everybody will give their best to developing not only the NCERT, but also strengthening the Ministry of Education through your contributions. With this, I would like to thank Dr. Professor Function, and I would also like to thank Honorable MOS, Dr. Sarkar sir and Dr. Ranjan Singh sir, because they have come as per the work allocation, both honorable ministers look more after the higher education side, but we are so happy that they could be present in a school education function, because this is really the starting point of a good correlation between school and higher education. And we would minister in the initiatives of NCERT. So may NCERT go from strength to strength, and I wish all of you all the very best. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I would request Honorable Ministers of State for Education, Government of India, to launch the Dictionary of Sociology for School, published in 3 languages, English, Hindi, and Urdu, created by NCERT. Thank you. Now I would request Honorable Minister of State for Education, Ministry of Education, Government of India, Dr. Subhash Sarkar, to share motivational words with us.
My senior minister, Sri Dharmendra Prasad, Dharmendra Pradhanji, Honorable Minister of Education, could not attend because of his preoccupation and hence sent his greetings through a message. Ministry, Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh Ji, Honorable Minister of State for Education, Government of India. Respected Mrs. Anita Karwal Ji, Secretary for School Education and Literacy, Ministry of Education. Our Joint Secretary, Madam Elis Chengshan Ji. Professor Sridhar Srivastav Ji, Director, NCERT. Major Harsh Kumar Ji, Secretary, NCERT. Professor Amarendra Prasad Behra, Chief Joint Director, CIET and NCERT, all faculty members, other distinguished guests, as well as all the principals, teachers and students, media people who are also virtually witnessing today's 61st Foundation Day ceremony. I'm extremely happy and feel honored to be part of the 61st Foundation Day celebration of NCERT today on 1st September 2021. On behalf of Ministry of Education, Government of India, I extend my warm greetings to all dignitaries present here to grace the occasion. I also extend my greetings to all the members of the constituent units of NCERT spread across the country to celebrate today's special occasion. Before I say something, please let me start with motto of NCERT and recite the sloka. Vidyaya Amritam Asnute Vidya Se Amrata Ka Ashwadan Karta Hai. It has been taken from the verse 11 of the Ishavasya Upanishad, and it has very beautiful meaning, life eternal through learning. I also found the design of the NCERT logo quite interesting and symbolic, which is three intertwined hansas originated from an Ashoka period relic. The logo of the NCERT shows hansa, the swan, a symbol of the pursuit of knowledge. It is not out of context to mention here that swan is also a vehicle of Ma Saraswati. And it is very auspicious that we also started with a devotional chant of Saraswati Vandana to seek Ma's blessings in today's 61st Foundation ceremony. That is research, development, and training. My dear friends, the celebration of 61st Foundation Day of NCERT marks the 60 years of its magnificent, memorable service to the country's education system. NCERT has not only been instrumental in the systemic reforms in educational system of the country, but it is also the resource center of innovation and development of school education and teacher education. As I have told earlier, NCERT has been entrusted with three duties as symbolized in its beautiful logo: research, development, and training. I firmly believe that it has carried out its duties to the fullest of its potential in every possible manner. NCERT is designated as an apex body of the Ministry of Education, Government of India for School Education. However, its obligation and operations are not merely limited to school education per se. The intrinsic and inherent nature of education links teacher education to the process of school education. And it is school education that paves the way to higher education. NCERT may be seen as an organization that functions as a bridge between the school and higher education. On one hand, its mandate is to design and develop the system. Well, while on the other hand, it has to develop resources for the system in terms of material as well as human resources, that is, teachers and teacher educators. In this context, may I share with you the view of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, our beloved former president, who believed and emphasized on tele-education and e-education methods to provide qualitative education in rural areas. According to him, education system should establish an intense relationship between the student and the teacher. As all walks of life is increasingly becoming technology intensive, the role of today's colleges or universities is not only to give degrees, but also to make students expert of the technology. Integration of the education and occupation is also necessary. Integration, that is, he also believed that there should be one skill-based subject along with the academic subjects. He was in favor of education system in which students develop themselves as self-learner and learn the process of learning. According to him, curriculum should be constructed, keeping in mind and the social and technological needs of the developed India. I am happy to learn that NCERT, with its constituent units, namely National Institute of Education, New Delhi, Central Institute of Education, New Delhi, Pandit Sundarlal Sharma Central Institute of Vocational Education, Bhopal, and five regional institutes of education at Ajmer, Bhopal, Bhubaneswar, Mysore, and Shillong has been working towards achieving the goal of providing quality education to all children. It brought our national curriculum frameworks, that is 1975, 1988, 2000 and 2005, followed by the preparation of syllabi, textual materials, evaluation tools, and innovative teacher training programs. Development and publication of textbooks from class 1 to 12 across subjects, areas in Hindi, Urdu, and English. 28 states, UTs adopt NCERT textbooks at different stages, including 18 states which have been given copyright permission. Development of competency-based learning outcomes for elementary school stage and developing capacities of the teachers and teacher educators. For implementing the same, conducting national achievement survey for class 3, 5, 8, and 10 at all India level and implementing post-NASH intervention. NCERT made attempts to implement examination reforms by way of introducing continuous and comprehensive evaluations in schools. It contributed towards inclusive education, building capacities of state UTs on curriculum adaptation for children with special needs, developing books based on universal design of learning, and also tactile map books. It is also organizing events like Kala Utshav, Yoga Olympiad, Jawaharlal Nehru Science and Mathematics Exhibition, ICT Mela, etc. Digitalization of educational resources and making them available on NROER. About 8,000 e-contents are available on NROER. E-Pathshala and mobile apps, course modules for massive open and online courses for school education system in 12 subject areas for class 9 to 12 for SWAM platform. It is conducting pre-service and in-service training programs. The RIEs have been offering four-year integrated pre-service innovative training program for quite long. NEP 2020 has advocated to offer such courses. As regards in service training of teachers, NCERT has launched a massive training program called NISTA for training of 42 lakh teachers in the country. NISTA for elementary teachers has been completed. Currently, NISTA for secondary school teachers is being offered through online mode on 29th July 2021. Our Honorable Prime Minister has launched a new version of teacher training called NISTA 2. Development of educational kits in science and mathematics and audiovisual materials has been a regular activity of NCERT, which is being used in schools throughout the country. It has also undertaken development curriculum for job roles in different vocational sectors, such as agriculture, tourism, construction, beauty, etc. According to National Skill Qualification Framework, that is NSQF, NCERT is currently engaged in development of National Curriculum Framework. Following bottom-up approach, NCERT charted the way of learning of students during COVID-19 pandemic period by developing alternative students through its program of Shahyog and is successfully running MANODARPAN program launched by Ministry of Education. Education has been recognized as the key sector to propel our nation towards progress. I'm happy to share with you that the new education policy 2020 envisions the holistic development of learners with emphasis on not only on enhancing school enrollment, academics, but also on qualities and skill to function as human personalities. Imparting of skills is viewed as key element of the modern education system. It has been time and again emphasized by the education minister that the NEP 2020 gives additional impetus to vocational education by introducing vocational subjects and training at school level. Two, skill development is the determining factor to realize the objectives of Atmanirbhar Bharat. When we talk about Make in India or Atmanirbhar Bharat, we need our youth to take a lead in the development of our country. And it is only possible from the practical aspect of education. Vocational training is often looked down upon. We need to sensitize our students. The NEP is a revolution in education system where vocational training is given importance and preference in building our nation. Universities, the school and educational institutes are still closed partly. But learning and education never stop. It continues whether the child is at home or at school. Under the direction of the Ministry of Education, NCERT has brought online education, students' learning enhancement guidelines, and also NISTA online are some of the initiatives which Ministry of Education has undertaken to address the challenges of school education emerged due to COVID-19. The pandemic has brought in new challenges. levels of access to technology need to be addressed. Surveys are revealing that in 2020, 5.5% of rural children did not enroll, while in 2018, it was 4%. Amongst 6 to 10 years age group, the difference is moreover, among enrolled children, 61.8% of families own smartphones, and WhatsApp have been found as the most popular mode of transmitting learning materials. The internet connectivity is also a factor in delivery of learning materials. The other area need to be looked into is parents' education. This is very 20. Parents' increasing level of education can be integrated into planning of learning improvement. Therefore, reaching parents at the high level is essential to understand how they can help their children. We also need to build the learning materials and methods for hybrid learning, combining traditional with low education and low resources. Having less access to learning opportunities poses greater challenge to the delivery mechanism. In lighter note, please allow me to share a fable on the folly of trying to run all kinds of children through the same mold with a vein in 1903 newspaper in Illinois published a fable called Jungle School Board with Animals in a scholastic setting, but the emphasis was different. The creatures were unable to. Mr. Kangaroo, Mr. Monkey, and these fellows held a meeting to agree upon their plans. What shall the animals? Children be taught in the animal school? That is the question, declared Mr. Monkey. Yes, that is the question, exclaimed Mr. Kangaroo and Mr. Elephant together. Natives will serve as teachers. No, indeed, shouted the other two in chorus. That would never do. They should be taught to jump, cried the kangaroo with emphasis. All of my relatives will be glad to teach them. No, indeed, yelled the other two in unison. And all my relatives will act as teachers. Elephants, all elephants don't. No, indeed, hold the other two together, that will never do. Well, what will do? They asked as they looked at each other in perplexity. Teach them to look wise, said Mr. Elephant. And so it was that none of them would yield. And when they saw there was no chance to agree, they all become angry and decided not to have any animal school at all. Therefore, in this context, the National Education Policy 2020, an excellent curricular and pedagogical framework for early childhood education for children up to the age of 8 will be developed by NCERT in two parts, namely a sub-framework for 0 to 3-year-olds and a sub-framework for 3 to 8-years-old. In accordance with the guidelines of NEP, the latest research on the National Early Childhood Care and Education. The numerous rich local traditions of India developed over millennia in early childhood care and education, involving art, stories, poetry, songs, and more, will also be suitably incorporated. The framework will serve as a guide both for parents as well as for early childhood educational institutions. Further, as per NEP 2020, with the quick but learn how to learn. Education must thus move towards less content and more towards learning about how to think critically and solve problems, how to be creative and multidisciplinary, and how to innovate, adapt, and absorb new material in novel and changing fields while learning by experiential, holistic, integrated, discovery-oriented, learner-centered, discussion-based, flexible, and of course, enjoyable. The curriculum must include basic arts, crafts, humanities, games, sports, and fitness, language, literature, culture, and values, in addition to science and mathematics. Education must build character, enable learners to be ethical, rational, compassionate, and caring, while at the same time prepare them for gainful fulfillment employment. The NEP 2020 is the guiding philosophy for changing the learning landscape, making education holistic, and for first education policy of the 21st century and replaces the 34-year-old national policy of education in the year 1986, which was established. Built on the foundation pillar of access, equity, quality, affordability, and accountability, this policy is aligned in the 2020 agenda for sustainable development by making both school and college education more holistic, flexible, multidisciplinary, and suited to 21st century needs, while aimed at bringing out the unique capabilities of each student. While addressing the nation recently, our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji has said that NEP 2020 is one of the major factors in the making of new India. He has also highlighted the importance of youth and the country's education system in nation building and welcomed the new national educational policy. He also said the policy will pave the way for a citizen who is attached to his roots, but is also a global citizen. New education policy will connect our students with their roots, but will also make them a global citizen, he added. In present times, when the world is witnessing rapid changes and outgrowth in terms of information and knowledge, leading to the idea of knowledge society, the role of NCERT become even more invisible and overall societal development in general. I firmly believe with full confidence that NCERT will continue with its magnificent service to the country With those words, I greet you all on celebrating 61st Foundation Day. May it bring the new years.
Thank you. Now I would request Honorable Minister of State for Education, Ministry of Education, Government.
I would like to start with thanks to address to this 61st Foundation Day of the NCERT. Then my colleague, Dr. Subhash Sarkar Ji, Srivastava, Director NCERT, and also my sister, L.S. Sang San, Joint Secretary, Ministry of Education, School Section, and then Joint Director CIET and Major Harsh Kumar, Secretary NCERT, all the family members of the NCERT, along with the constituent institutes and regional office, and to be here in this solemn occasion and also expressing the pleasure of the 61st Foundation Day of the NCERT. Subhash Sarkar Ji, very illuminating, and also with great honor he delivered his address. Successful 60 years of event created by the NCERT to shape the national education policy and to bring a unified 61st Foundation Day celebration of NCERT. On behalf of my Ministry of Education, Government of India, I express my warm greeting to NCERT family, the members of the constituent units NCERT celebrating this day in different parts of the country. The celebration of Foundation Day of an organization is a day to rejoice its glorious past and to reflect and reconnect with the achievement and aspirations. Foundation Day is therefore an occasion 60 years of remarkable journey of its contributions in the field of school education as well as teachers' education. It was NCERT was established with multiple aims and objectives. It was envisaged as an institution to involve and enact the educational policies of the country and remarkable work not only in emulating the global trends and challenges in the field of education, but also in the systematic reforms addressing to the historical, social, and cultural challenges in Indian education system. Today is the 21st century. Education has to sustain and survive various changes. With the advancement of science and technology on one hand, and the phenomena of globalization on the other, is positive villages. These two phenomena have radical impact on education too. Here, I would also like to share some of the story. So for example, we have to talk about the impacting educations. Yesterday, our senior education minister has given a beautiful ideas how to impact, and it may. There was a story, of course, based on the study of democracy, how it impacts the entire society. That too, their film was shooting in China. It's a communist country, not the democracy. How they start their education, giving the impact to the whole family and whole society. That kind of thing, we have to be involved in this system of changing the curriculum. Say there was a student election. These are all common features. Practicing in all the institutions, selecting captain of the class or a monitor of the class. So in that lesson, what they are doing, the school teachers try to get many information so that when you deliver lecture for campaigning your candidacy in your class, that campaign should prove and should accept by your colleagues in the class. So the boy came, three boys go to different families and ask to their parent how to speak and how to influence my classmate. And that create the whole system of education. And they reconcile what's the role of the student, what is the role of a democracy, what the people will do. These are all the impact. That kind of impactious system of education should be collaborated in the new sense of syllabus. And secondly, this is another story I will tell you later on. Our honor for Atma Nirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, through the crisis of the pandemic and technology, help us to continue to impact education to our children. NEP 2022 has focused on enhancing human capital, making our children self-reliant and integrated holistic personalities. This brings the focus on skill development as the most expected outcome of education attainment. The vision to make the youth self-reliant through skill-based educations and ambitions in the National Education Policy 2020 would require bring about revolutionary feature in imparting education. NCERT's role in this very critical, this is very critical. It is presently working towards development of national curriculum framework for school education, early childhood care, and education, adult education, and teachers' education. It is helping the states to develop their own state curriculum framework. During the pandemic time, NCERT developed alternative academic calendar. It's a very great achievement for students, for all classes and subjects, so that their learning is not affected when the schools are closed. Here, how could we correlate to our syllabus about the Swasthya Bharat? Here I recall my childhood in the schools. Every Saturday was the school was closed earlier. And also we were asked by the school teachers, you have to clean your campus, your classroom, even your toilet. That was taught in our LP school stays. And that gives an impact that, oh, this school belongs to me. How could we impart to our present new syllabus so that automatically or inbuilt the system of the student to clean, so that Prime Minister's vision on Swasthya Bharat can continue and sustainably we can keep our country neat and clean. And then another story is that I would like to share another story. When the jungles are very fast, the environment condition was very good, and the population of human population is less, animal population is controlling that time. That time we need to educate ourselves how to catch a tiger. So now the institution was established long back. So we continue this institution established, and another establishment, we give the training to students generation by generation how to catch the tiger till today. That means there is no tiger, tiger population is very limited. Still then institution is there. So the production of our student, where do we employ it? Then he or she will go to his village and will establish another institution called how to catch a tiger. But this is not the case in NCERT. NCERT looking all these changes and try to adopt the changing situations with science and technology and globalization. So it creates a good education system, particularly in the school system. Education, therefore, need to be reformed to adopt these changes and also to adopt a new way of learning. Here I would also remember one more thing that was during the People's Science Movement under Professor Yos Pal, that was in 1987, 89, like that. There some system has come up, joy of learning. So in some of your publication, perhaps I come across about the part washing, and many things are there in your the reference reading books published by the NCERT, and that will give the motto of ECLEVA model of education. ECLEVA means not the school established by the under the tribal affairs, the ECLEVA of Dronacharya. They have to learn. Even the science, we can learn without lab. Go to the field, touch the bark of the tree, and start to establish their imaginations. And from that, teacher has to guide. This is the thing, why the leaf of the flower is different. And that kind of things can self education, and that fills the joy of learning. That kind of system, I hope it will continue. Thus, publication like that of your Bart Wasi and others, and NCERT can. I have seen a lot of books published by the NCERT, and that thrills to me also. So I believe the sky is the limit when it comes to innovations and learning. The emphasis on skill-based school education will be a great step towards making Bharat Atmanirbhar. The role of NCERT in this process is paramount. My best wishes for the future endeavor. With this few words, thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you. Now I would request respected Secretary NCERT Major Harsh Kumar for the vote of thanks.
राष्ट्रीय शैक्षिक अनुसंधान और प्रशिक्षण परिषद के इस गौरवशाली 60 वर्ष पूरे होने पर इस सभा के मुख्य अतिथि माननीय शिक्षा मंत्री भारत सरकार श्री धर्मेंद्र प्रधान जी, जो कि हमारे मुखिया भी हैं, वैसे भी एनसीईआरटी के अध्यक्ष हैं, उनके आशीर्वचनों को सुना, जिसमें कि उन्होंने एनसीईआरटी के का न केवल उत्साह वर्धन किया, एनसीईआरटी परिवार की तरफ से मैं उनका हृदय से आभार व्यक्त करता हूं। इस सभा में उपस्थित माननीय राज्य मंत्री श्री सुमित सरकार जी का भी, श्री सुभाष सरकार जी का भी मैं एनसीईआरटी परिवार की तरफ से हार्दिक अभिनंदन एवं धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूं कि उन्होंने इस विषम परिस्थिति में भी यहां पर पहुंचकर अपने बहुमूल्य समय से समय निकालकर न केवल सीआरटी के कार्यों के बारे में बताया तथा बहुत एक सरल तरीके से उन्होंने शिक्षा में किस प्रकार से परिवर्तन किया जाए या समय अनुकूल किस तरह से परिवर्तन करना है, इस प्रकार पर भी, इस पर भी प्रकाश डाला। मैं उनका पुनः धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूं। हमारे माननीय राज्य मंत्री श्री राजकुमार रंजन जी, जिन्होंने बहुत सरल तरीके से फिर से उन्हीं बातों को बताया और प्रधानमंत्री जी के जो अभीष्ट कार्यक्रम है उसके बारे में उन्होंने बताया कि उसमें एनसीईआरटी हो सकती है और किस तरह से इसको कवर करना है। मैं माननीय का भी हृदय से आभार व्यक्त करता हूं। हमारे शिक्षा मंत्रालय की संयुक्त सचिव श्रीमती चांगसंग महोदया ने यह बताया कि एनसीईआरटी के कार्यों को उन्होंने कितने करीब से देखा है और किस प्रकार एनसीईआरटी सहभागिता से अपने संपूर्ण कार्यक्रमों का निष्पादन करता है। वह इस गौरवशाली क्षणों में हमारे साथ रही, इसके लिए भी मैं उनका हृदय से आभार व्यक्त करता हूं। एनसीईआरटी के सम्माननीय निदेशक महोदय प्रोफेसर श्रीधर श्रीवास्तव जी का भी मैं धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूं। जिस तरह से भी माननीय राज्य मंत्री जी ने बताया कि एनसीईआरटी का लोगो है तीन हंसों का जोड़ा, और जिस तरह से एक साथ संगठित होकर के वो अपने कार्यों का, वो समुद्र से मोती निकालते हैं और मां सरस्वती के वाहक भी हैं, उसी प्रकार से एनसीईआरटी के संपूर्ण सदस्य एक साथ मिलकर इस अमृत का मंथन करके बच्चों के लिए एक सही दिशा निर्देश लगातार प्रेषित कर रहे हैं। मैं माननीय निदेशक महोदय का भी धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूं। हमारे संयुक्त निदेशक महोदय प्रोफेसर अमरेंद्र बेहरा जी कल अपने जितने भी उनके संकाय सदस्य हैं, कर्मचारी हैं, अधिकारी हैं, उनका वह जिसे कहते हैं ग्राउंड सोल्जर की तरह खड़े होकर के उसका निर्देशन करते हैं और हर कार्यक्रम को सफल रूप से परिणित कराते हैं। मैं उनका भी एनसीईआरटी परिवार की तरफ से धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूं। हमारे संकाय अध्यक्ष और इस कार्यक्रम की संपूर्ण रूपरेखा बनाने वाली हमारी संकाय अध्यक्षा महोदय प्रोफेसर अंजुम सीबिया, प्रोफेसर ज्योत्सना, प्रोफेसर रंजना अरोड़ा, के साथ सारे हमारे संकाय सदस्य हैं जिन्होंने इस कार्यक्रम में अपनी भूमिका निभाई है। इस कार्यक्रम नहीं, एनसीईआरटी के संपूर्ण कार्यक्रम, जैसे एनसीईआरटी का जो भी कार्यक्रम होता है, न केवल ये कार्यक्रम बल्कि हमें हरेक जो हमें कार्य मिलता है वो हमारे लिए एक मिशन की तरह होता है और उसमें सभी की बहुत जो भूमिका होती है, उन सब संकाय सदस्यों का मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूं। हमारे सभी अधिकारीगण जो कि हर कार्यक्रम में खड़े रहते हैं और अपने भूमिका को निभाते हैं, उनका भी मैं धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूं। हमारे जो हमारे क्षेत्रीय शिक्षा संस्थान के प्राचार्य हैं, वहां के संकाय सदस्य, हमारे पूर्व निदेशक, जितने निदेशक हैं उनका, और जिन्होंने भी, जैसा कि हमारे निदेशक महोदय ने बताया कि जिन्होंने भी एनसीईआरटी में अपना योगदान दिया है, उन सभी का मैं धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूं। और साथ ही आपको यह विश्वास दिलाता हूं कि एनसीईआरटी परिवार इस बात पर सतत कार्यरत है, अपने इस महामारी के दौरान भी एनसीईआरटी ने एक भी दिन कृत और परिमार्जन ये लगातार होता रहेगा हर क्षण हर दिन, और मेरा पूरा विश्वास है कि एनसीईआरटी नई ऊंचाइयां हासिल करेगा। इसी के साथ मैं पुनः सबका धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूं। जय हिंद, जय भारत।
धन्यवाद सर। इंडिया इज अ कंट्री ऑफ यूनिटी इन डाइवर्सिटी एंड विदाउट द नेशनल एंथम दिस सेरेमनी इज इनकम्प्लीट। A national anthem video has been created by the students of Regional Institute of Education, Mysuru. Let us all stand in the honor of nation and show unity as always.
Janagana mana adhinayaka jaya hind Bharat bhagya vidhata पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल वंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मागे गाहे तव जय गाथा जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
This also, yeah.